In this session, we are practicing RSA example. So let us begin the session. Learning outcome: at the end of this session, students will be able to calculate ciphertext using the RSA algorithm. As we have seen in the previous session, RSA encryption and decryption algorithm, to encrypt a message M of the sender, first obtain a public key of the recipient, that is E and N, then compute ciphertext by formulating M raised to E mod N, where M is between 0 and N. And to decrypt the ciphertext C of the owner, uses their private key PR, that is DN, and then compute to find out M with the formula C raised to D mod N. Now, before that, it is important to generate a pair of key. Each user generates a public-private key pair by selecting two large primes at a random, let's say P and Q, then computing their system modulus for N is equal to P multiplied by Q, and note phi of N is equal to P minus 1 multiplied by Q minus 1. Now, time to select random E, which is encryption key, lies between 0 and phi of N. And another important thing is GCD of E and phi of N is equal to 1. And now time to calculate decryption key D with the formula ED is equal to 1 mod phi N. And D is between 0 and N. So, public encryption key E and N and private decryption key D and N. Now, let's check out the examples. The first one, with a given content, P is equal to 3, Q is equal to 11, E is a 7 and M is 5. So, E and M is already given, E is already given, and with P 3 and Q 11. So, sit with a pen and paper. So, first step, N P multiplied by Q. The second step, to find out phi of N. Now, time to determine D such that D E mod phi of N is 1. So, D multiplied by 7 mod 20 is equal to 1, and D is less than 20. Now, trial and error, just start from 1, etc., etc. Now, we at a 3. So, 3 into 7, 21, mod 21, LHS is equal to RHS. So, you can fix on 3. So, D3, E7. So, ciphertext, 5 raised to 7, y 5, m is 5, mod 33, by performing calculations 14, and original message, it is compulsory to find out 5, so 14 raised to 3, mod 33, 5. Hope you all are getting how to perform the calculations. The main part here is determine D. Now just check out the second example. What are the content? PQ 511, so 55, phi of N, P minus 1, Q minus 1, 40. E is given, so no time or no selection of E. Now E is 3, so DE is equal to 1 mod phi N. So 3D is equal to 1 mod 40. Again, by performing calculations, by doing trial and error, by applying theorems, we are able to determine D is equal to 27. So, time to compute ciphertext, 9 raised to 3, 9 is our message, mod 55. So, by calculating 55, and M is equal to 14 raised to 27, mod 55, okay. So, original plain text 9. Hope you solved these two. Now just another type of example. Read carefully. In a public key system using RSA, intercept the ciphertext C, which is 10, send to a user whose public key is 5 and n is equal to 35. Now time to do the reverse calculation to find out the plain text M. Okay. So let P be 5 and Q be 7. It is assumption. For calculation, we have chosen the small numbers. Actual, they are large and random. Okay. So N is equal to P multiply by Q, that is 5 multiply by 7, 35, and 5 of N, P minus 1, Q minus 1, 24. Now here we are going to select E such that GCD of phi of n and E is equal to 1 and E is between 1 and phi of n. So E is by doing calculation GCD of 24. So 1, no. 2, no, it is not a common. 3, it is also the GCD is not equal to 1 means 4, no, 5, yes, so E is 5. Now time to generate D or compute D. So this is also equivalent formula. D is equal to e raised to 1 mod means mod minus 1 mod phi of n, which is equivalent to ED 1 mod phi of n, or ED mod phi of n is equal to 1. How you want to write? It depends on you. Now we have E phi u, phi of n is 24. So phi u d mod 24 is equal to 1. That is our by calculation. And we determine d is equal to 5. So now private key is ready. Yes, d and n, phi u 35. Public key is already ready. E, n. Now decryption algorithm. M is equal to C raised to D mod N. So 10 raised to 5 mod 35. So by calculation we get original message 5. And now we will cross check. Ciphertext M raised to E mod N, that is 5 raised to 5 mod 35 means 10. So our calculation is correct. Now dear student, please pause the video and try to answer. In the RSA algorithm, we select two random large values P and Q. Which of the following is the property of P and Q? P and Q should be divisible by phi of n. P and Q should be co-prime. P and Q should be prime. P by Q should give no remainder. Just revise. Okay, so P and Q should be prime. That is a basic property while selecting two random P and Q. Okay, now what are the RSA issues? As we have seen that RSA is most popular public key encryption algorithm. RSA is computationally intense. Yeah, that is basic. Commonly used key length are 1024 bits. The plain text should be smaller than key length. The encrypted text is the same as key length and generally used to encrypt secret key. Means it is used to send a secret key from one to another in a symmetric encryption. Look out here. So use of a public key encryption system for distribution of private key. Now, what are the potential attacks possible on a RSA algorithm? Brute force key search. Infeasible given size of numbers. So, timing attacks on running of a decryption can infer operand size based on time taken. The third one is mathematical attacks. So based on a difficulty of computing phi of n by factorizing modulus and chosen ciphertext attacks. So these four types of attacks are possible. So brute force key search, timing attacks, mathematical attacks, and chosen ciphertext attacks. So now summarize within a couple of minutes what we have seen for RSA and RSA encryption decryption algorithm key generation. Okay, so RSA public key encryption uses two keys. So one to encrypt and other to decrypt. The keys are interchangeable. We cannot interchange between public and private key. For example, at one time D is public key, at another time D is private key. This is not a case with RSA. The keys are interchangeable. One key is public and other is private. RSA uses exponential in GF of n for large n. N is a product of two large primes. Public key encryption algorithm has a lots of support from mathematical formulas, theorems. RSA keys are EN and DN, where ED mod of phi of n is 1. Means how E and D are interrelated, that is also important. So given the keys, both encryption and decryption are easy, but given one key, finding the other key is hard. That is important. And the message size should be less than the key size. Use large keys, 5 and 2 bits and larger. So these are the important factors or characteristic of a RSA algorithm. And as we have discussed that RSA, or there are lots of public key encryption algorithm, the one important use or application is key distribution of secret key while used for symmetric encryption algorithm. So this is a reference. Thank you.